Hi there everybody, and welcome to one of my videos. In today's video I have this Mercedes C-Class. This is a 2006, the W203 chassis, and I'm going to be changing the V-belt or alternator belt or serpentine belt, whatever you want to call it. It's got so many names these days. Okay, so to remove the V-belt, just need to make a bit of room, so I'm gonna remove this here. Yes, get this little pin out, loosen that. And with a flathead screwdriver, I'm just going to release those two locking pins there. This is a bit fragile, all this you can see is a bit broken already. To remove this end, you need to lift this bit up to be able to pull it out. And basically the way I do it is, I just push the screwdriver through here, because it needs to be released from this plastic bit here. So the best way is to push it here, and then you can pull that out. Now we got more access to the belt area here. The tensioner for this belt is down here, so to get access to that belt we need to remove this plastic intake. So basically I'm talking about this one here. We need to put it to one side. We're not going to touch the coolant pipes or anything. We're just going to remove everything that is related to this. We're gonna need one of these again, one of these star type of sockets. This is a size 10, E10, and that is to undo two of those little bolts down there, which we're gonna see in a minute. First I'm going to undo this Jubilee clips here. You can use a screwdriver to undo those, just a flat head, or I sometimes just use the a 7mm socket that fits on those a bit better than a flat head screwdriver, which is the flat head screwdriver might not fit very well at that angle. Okay, and I'm also going to undo little plastic clip my brake if I try to remove it, so I'm just going to undo this little bolt here as well. It's the same size as the ones at the bottom. Okay, just be careful when removing that, it might be a bit stuck and you don't want to damage it. Now down here, we can separate this pipe. We pull on that, pull that clip, and just remove this. And basically in there is also where we have these screws. Do that. Okay, that's one of them. I mean, these are sitting basically if you follow this plastic bit here, we just follow that plastic bit all the way in, that's where it is, and the other one is just down at the bottom. It's two of them that go in like so. So that's where the other one is, basically. Really easy to see, but it's down there. This is the one here, basically. Okay, once we've got all of that out of the way, this will then move and you can disconnect it from that end there. And that's it, just drop it down there. That will leave you access to the tensioner. The tensioner is just sitting here. Okay, so to get that belt off, we're gonna need a socket, one like this. That is size, where is that size? T60. A T60, which fits just at the bottom of the tensioner. I'm also gonna use an extended wrench, and I'm also going to use a little pin, something like this, or you can use a drill bit, it's about 5 mil, to lock the tensioner in place. Now, just to show you where the tool goes in, if we look, if we just look on this mirror, I don't know if it's visible there or not. Okay, so I just put the mirror down there because it's hard to get the camera. But there's basically that hole there where you can put the tool. It's that one there. And that's where the tool is going to go to turn the tensioner. And that is just sitting, like I said, it's just sitting at the bottom left of the tensioner wheel. And then I've got the little pin here, and that goes on a little hole that is on the side of the tensioner. You can see it. Okay, so make sure the tool is sitting nice in that hole. Basically, once I turn this, I'm gonna try to get the pin in there. It's hard to see. Okay. As I move that, you can see the belt getting released, and now okay, so I've got the little pin in place. Now I'm just gonna take the belt out. It's quite loose while I hold the tension a little bit up there. Just remove the belt, like so. Once you remove one wheel, just release the tensioner. The little pin is gonna keep it in place. Okay, so it's quite a long belt. It's a very long belt. It's been there a long time. You can check the belt usually for cracks and things, but this one is not too bad. It has been there a while though. The cutting hasn't done many miles, but they can also get dry and snap with time, even if they don't look worn. Okay, so this is my new belt. It's a Continental 7PK2418 Conti V multi rib. Now, if you made a little drawing of how this goes back, then that would be a good thing. Because they can be confusing. But I did make a drawing anyway. Okay, I've got it sitting nicely all around, so this will be the bit, the last bit that I need to push in there. But make sure all the wheels are sitting properly into the little grooves. Now we can release the tension again. I'm going to remove the little pin. And then push it in there. Never put your fingers in between the wheels in case the tensioner slips, otherwise your finger will get caught in there and that will be painful. So that is on now. I can release the tension. And that's it. So what we need to do next is refit everything back. Okay, that's pretty much it. Now I'm gonna start the car, make sure it's running okay. So everything is just fine there, you can just finish off. Feeling that. And the job is done, so hope this video helps, and thanks for watching.